What is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, I will be unveiling the official MDT 2019 Royal Rumble stage. Lo and behold, ladies and gentlemen, it is the official MDT Royal Rumble stage. Would you look at this piece of beautifulness right here? My Lord God, I am super duper excited for this thing. I'm super hyped. It makes me even more happy and ready for the Royal Rumble of our pick fed. But I gotta give a huge shout out to the creator and the builder of this diorama, if you will, or stage, if you want to call it that. It is Al from Al_figures on Instagram. He also has a YouTube channel where he breaks down how he makes these things, and he goes through the process. He has a really awesome YouTube channel. I found him before I even started my own channel. He actually inspired me to get into action figures and action figure photography and dioramas and all that stuff. He is the one that inspired me from finding his YouTube channel, and you guys can go follow him on Instagram and subscribe to his channel. All the links are in the description there. But he is an absolute beast. I hit him up to make this piece. You guys can see it actually continues on. You guys can see how far this thing goes. I think it's 19 inches deep is what he said. I haven't measured it or anything, but I do believe that's what Al said it was. We'll get into all the details of it, but I also want to give a huge shout out to Mac_decals, my boy on Instagram. He is the one that pretty much inspired this too, because he created a replica of the Royal Rumble 2000 stage. You guys know what I'm talking about. I'll pop it up on the screen. I posted it on my YouTube community page a while back as well, and I talked about, you know, my inspiration for it. He custom built it, and it looks incredible. And I figured, like, when I saw his brought to life in figure form for WWE action figures, I said, bro, I gotta cop this for my Royal Rumble. I want to have something similar to this for my Royal Rumble. So I want to give a huge shout out to Mac_decals. You guys need to go follow him on Instagram, because he is a very, very talented customizer. He makes epic customs, and he makes awesome things related to WWE figures. So definitely go follow him. But he inspired this as well, and I wanted to give him some credit there. But let's get into this thing, man. It's an absolute beast of a project. I can't wait to see what it looks like in the arena. I'm not going to do it on video for you guys today. Maybe we'll do it, you know, when we do the arena showcase for the Royal Rumble as we approach closer. We'll do that, but this thing is absolutely incredible. I know it doesn't have the taxi up top, but I'm gonna add a few things. I'm probably gonna add some stuff over on this side and this side, as far as maybe a wall. And then I'm thinking about I think the Royal Rumble is gonna be an MSG, just like the Royal Rumble from 2000. I think that was MSG. So I think I'm going to add some elements of New York in here, whether it be a Statue of Liberty or if it's going to be a taxi. It's going to be up here, and it's going to say MDT Royal Rumble somewhere up here to finalize the project. But it looks epic, and I mean, Al absolutely killed this thing. You guys can see on his channel, he talked about, you know, everything he used for this. But you guys can see, here's the entrance way, and this door doesn't open. However, if I wanted to, I could remove, oops, sorry about that. You can remove the door. And this is a working light up here, which is absolutely amazing. We can go ahead and get into the scale. Here's a quick shot of Finn Balor doing his entrance at the Royal Rumble. And you guys can see, let's say we just put him there at the entrance stage, and then we cut off these lights, and then we flick on this light right here. And this is for those special entrances, you know what I'm saying? So there's an option that you can do that Al provided. It looks absolutely beast in the freaking darkness. I think that looks amazing for, you know, those certain people's entrances. I think this will do wonders for them. And then, of course, you can cut that off. And then there is a vent on the bottom there. If you guys can see that at his feet, there is a vent and there is a space. All you gotta do is lift up this piece on the ground, maybe with like a few sheets of paper or like a binder or something, a book. But you lift up this piece and you can put a light under there, and you can get some light coming from the bottom if you want to. So there's that part of it. I mean, if you get in here, there's some graffiti that Al killed. He's actually a really good, he's been a graffiti artist in real life, not just for figures, like actual graffiti with spray cans and stuff. He's actually been a graffiti artist for, I think, 15 years, he said, or longer. And that's how he killed all this. He put MDT down here. Over here on the side panel, you can see MDT. Just tons of detail on this thing. He added like little bricks that are removable. All these bricks that you see, I can remove them. I can put them, oh snap, knocked over the wall. I can put those wherever I want. And this is just, look at the shots, man. We can do so many great things. I don't know the full card for the Royal Rumble yet, but I know it's gonna be a stacked card, and you know that it's gonna be better. Every pay-per-view we get better and better, and it's gonna be even better than sold out, if you can believe that. But right here, We have some more things. I think it says days. I don't know what that means, but you know how graffiti's kind of random. You know, people repping their group or whatever, and they put their stuff down. And I think he just killed this, man. It's so freaking beautiful. Like, well, you can zoom in back here. It says MDT back there. It has a few other graffiti things. I think one of the things that I love the most about it, not only the detail and the road, because, you know, it's like the road to MYDAMNTOYS or the road to MYDAMNmania. I still haven't decided on a name yet, but I think MYDAMNTOYS is just so perfect. But it's like a road because it leads to, you know, the main event of MYDAMNTOYS or MYDAMNmania. That is what that represents there. So I think that's so sick that there's a road that leads from the beginning of the Royal Rumble to the ring, and that's how you get to MYDAMNTOYS or whatever it is. But this is beautiful. I love this to death. This back wall is so sick. You can see all the rust detail he put in it. You can see the little lock chain. I think he said his girlfriend put that in there, and she did an excellent job on that. I think that looks so official. You know, it's like a locked off door. What else we got in here? I mean, it's literally all the way around too, guys. Like if you pull it away, it's on the outsides too. It's not like he just half-assed it. It's actually completely, from every angle, this thing is completely covered, and I think he did a fantastic job on it. This is in two separate pieces. I think he said the only way to, you know, level it out is just get like a sheet of paper to make sure they're on the same level. And, you know, I can like lift it up or whatever I want to do. I'm not sure if I'm going to lift it up. I'm sure I will. But at the end here, I may have to put like a little ramp or something or hide that with the barricade because there's not a little ramp. It just kind of, there's like an inch here that kind of falls off, but I can fix that no problem. Just a beautiful piece, man. Just such a beautiful piece. There's also some gappage right here. You can see there's a gap there on that side and a gap on that side. He did that so you can put some lighting through here. You could remove these if you want. It's all magnetized, by the way, which I'll show you guys here in a second, but it is magnetized. If I want to use that back door for another pay-per-view or I want to use some of these pieces for something other than the Royal Rumble, I can totally do that. And I think that Al absolutely knocked this out of the park. It's definitely, I think he killed this. He killed my, he's the one that made my general manager's office that you see on the pick fed as well. And I think that this is even better. I think that this is, you know, a lot more original. And it looks incredible. I can't wait to put this in the arena, like I said. Get the Royal Rumble going. And just seeing this in real life and seeing this in person and playing around with it and posing figures on it and everything is just it makes me just want to get in there and film like six Vindications and six MDT Lives in a row. Just it hypes me up so much. But there again, you can see Finn Balor doing his entrance there at the Royal Rumble. Where will he show up at the Rumble? Who knows? But it's looking good. He looks good up in there. And I'm super duper excited. But like I said, Al Figures, go follow him on Instagram and subscribe to his channel. I mean, we could spend like an hour getting into the details of this thing, guys. I mean, look at it looks so official. It looks so realistic. He even has, like I said, the rust on the back door there. He literally just destroyed this thing. He literally destroyed it. And you guys know I'm stupid. I like to use that as a compliment. But he literally destroyed it. He freaking destroyed it. And I'm super happy for it. And again, a huge shout out to Mac for the inspiration behind this as well. One more thing I want to add is these little green leaves you see growing up through the road and like the debris and stuff. Some of this stuff's permanent just because you want to give it some wear and tear without giving it too much wear and tear. And those are just like little aquarium leaves, I think, for like fish tanks. I think they work well in the dio. I think they create a bit of contrast. You know, it's not all blacks and grays and stuff like that, so I think that works too. I like that it's original from the WWF Royal Rumble. I'm glad that it's, you know, not the exact same. There are a little bit of differences. I think the road for the WWE or WWFs went all the way to the entrance. Mine's a bit different. You got a little walk space there. We have two more episodes of MDT Vindication and then two more episodes of MDT Live before we get to the Royal Rumble. But I am super freaking excited to get started on all of that and get it ready. I mean, Vindication's already underway. I'm working on that every day just because I know you guys don't like waiting around. But with the holidays, it kind of slowed me down a little bit. You know, you got to shop. You got to do all of those things. You got to get all of that knocked out. And I was trying to take a break, you know, rest myself so I could come into the new year very strong. But I hope you guys did enjoy this video. I'd love to know your guys' thoughts on the official Royal Rumble stage. I may add some pictures at the end so you guys can, you know, get another feel of how it's going to look at the Rumble and everything. I just think that looks so, like, look at that shot right there, guys. That is so epic. I love this. Maybe we can change, like, the perspective of the arena, you know. Like, at the Royal Rumble 2000, they had it in the center. So it would be, like, the back wall. Like, when you're looking from the hard cam, the back wall would be the entrance. And then the side, where the entrance usually is would be the sides of the arena, and it wouldn't be, you know, in the middle there. But I don't know. We'll have to figure all that stuff out. But a huge shout out to Al for the epic diorama, the beautiful Royal Rumble MDT stage that we are going to be using for our pay-per-view. Huge shout out to Mac as well, guys. Go check out all of their links are in the description. Very talented artists, very talented customizers, and they're amazing. So definitely go give them a follow and subscribe to Al's YouTube channel. Subscribe to my channel if you enjoy more content like this. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.